Hi, it's Meredith Marsh here, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through the very simple steps for adding music in iMovie. So when you have a video project in iMovie and you want to add a little bit of emotion, a little bit of dimension, background music is the perfect way to do that. And it's so easy to do inside of iMovie. Let's take a look. Now, I already have a project going here inside of iMovie, and Epidemic Sound is my favorite place to find background music. I can browse through here. I can find what's new. I can find the genre or the mood or the theme that I'm looking for. I like to usually start with my saved sounds. These are the things that I have found while browsing Epidemic Sound that I really like this one, for example. So I'm going to hit download on this track. It's going to ask me if I want the stems or the full mix. I'm just going to use the full mix here. Now the MP3 file is saved right here on my desktop. But before I pull this into iMovie, I want to show you how to save some headaches for yourself later on. Whenever I download a background track from Epidemic Sound, whether it's music or sound effects, I always keep them organized inside of my external hard drive. So I have an assets folder, and inside of the assets folder is any B-roll that I might reuse, graphics, music, and sound effects. So when I download a sound effect from Epidemic Sound, I put it right there in that folder, so it's always in the same spot. Same thing with music. When I download a background track, it goes into my Epidemic Sound folder. You can see I have a lot of favorites here inside of this folder. That way I don't have to re-download them every single time I create a video. So I'm going to take this track and drag it over into this folder. And you can see we have this right here at the top. Adding music to iMovie is so easy and so simple. And the way that I like to do it is just take the file from the folder and drag it down onto the timeline and then let go. It's going to come down on the timeline. It should be green. We can see the waveforms, and it's right there in this project that we're working on. Now, if for some reason that method doesn't work for you, you can import this file just like you would import your, still images or your video files. You have this import button right here at the top. So if I select that, we have this hard drive selected, and then you can go through your folders and locate this file that you just downloaded. So I'm gonna come under assets, and then I have music, and then under Epidemic Sound. Now the name of this file was Star Cluster. So I'm just going to find it right here. I'm gonna make sure this is selected, and it is the right one is selected. I'm going to choose import selected down here in the bottom right. Now, if I move myself out of the way here, you'll be able to see that we now have that file. It's going to be green. You may have a little yellow or red. It's going to depend on the clip itself, because those are the waveforms that you're seeing. So I'm going to select this and drag it down on my timeline. And before I let go of my mouse button, I can decide where I want it to actually go on the timeline. So you can see here that the green is the audio clip. That is the background music that we just downloaded from Epidemic Sound and is now inside of our iMovie project. And you can edit this clip just like you would any video clip that you have. So you can trim the beginning or trim the end. You can also chop this up, split the clip, and then you have multiple different pieces of this background music. You can move it into an entirely different position or even put it in a different order here. One more thing I want to show you is how to really quickly and easily adjust the volume. So you have this volume bar here, and if you just grab it and drag it down, you can go down to 4%, 6%, wherever you want it to be here, so that the background music you added to iMovie doesn't overpower your entire project and hurt the ears of your viewer. You can also use this little dot that comes up as kind of a handle to fade your background music in, or on the back end, you can fade your background music out. Now you know how simple it is to add music in your iMovie project.